as far as the Baptist Student Union, whatever the Baptists do there. And,
yeah.
And he's a great drummer. He's a drummer down at Vertical Church. And no telling, we're going to see him on television one day doing all this stuff. He's good. Okay. Ethan, share with us.
Welcome, everybody. It's so good to see you all. You guys are, I think it's the beautiful, this is the most beautiful church. There's no bias in that whatsoever. I just, walking around this morning, saying welcome to everybody, and getting hugs and kisses and handshakes and all that good stuff. It's just, it's good to see old friends, new friends. It's good to see how, you know, big our church is, and it's just a blessing to be here in front of you guys. And I would like to share how big of an impact that the church has had on me as an individual in my walk with Christ. And I'm going to start with my family and I. We moved here in 2001, in the summer of 2001, and I think that was about 13 years ago. And I remember when Holly Longer came. I don't know if any of you remember her, but she came to our door and invited us to Vacation Bible School here at First Baptist. And my mom and dad were like, well, you know, let's send our kids to this. This seems like a nice church we get plugged into. And so we decided to go. I was in first grade at Scurlock Elementary School. Linda Pope was the youth minister at the time. She was in charge of the Vacation Bible School. And that was the first affiliation I've had with First Baptist Church. And it was a great one. I thoroughly enjoyed myself, and I know the rest of my family did. We felt welcomed here, which is big for a church, so I really appreciate that, and my first contact with you all. So after that, my mom and dad said, this is it, this will be our church. And so from there on out, every Sunday, every Wednesday, we would go to church Wednesday night, get a good grub in the Gatlin Hall, and every Sunday morning we would wake up, go to church. I remember my first Sunday school teacher was Miss Maisel Connell, and I remember her, and I remember seeing her every Sunday. Miss Doris Lawson would play piano in her class, and then that's what really touched me. I used to walk over, and I would stand right beside her and watch her play, and I was like, wow, playing piano, this is really fun. And that's actually what started my an interest to play piano. And so I started doing that. My parents would always take us to church events. I was a Loyal Ambassador, just like Mr. Douglas was. I played basketball for the church. Mr. Dover helped us all out with that. And then after I graduated from Sunday school with Ms. Connell, my other brothers, Heath and Hal, we went to Sunday school taught by Mr. Larry Stark. And so I was there. We would always be part of the plays with Brianne, and it was just a great time. Being involved with all the fellowship and all the events and stuff was just really touching for us and our family. It was later in 2001 where Pastor Robinson, the pastor prior to Pastor Tom, he baptized me here, right up there, actually. And so that was my baptism. And after that, Pastor Robinson left, and Pastor Tom and Linda came, and is he behind me? No, okay. Pastor Tom and Lincoln came, and I just remember meeting them for the first time. I was like, what a beautiful couple, what a beautiful people, and I can't wait to see how's he going to do as pastoring this church, and how Miss Linda is going to do right beside him. And so they made a big impact. And right before I got old enough to be in the youth, Miss Linda stepped down and went to go do other bigger things. And I remember her last children's sermon over here, and it was a good one. And she used me for worry. She was talking about worrying, and that's something I've been struggling with since the day I was born. And so I remember that. And my mom and dad can attest to that, I'm sure. But so I remember that, and Linda left, and that was right before I was coming to youth group. And then I remember Amanda and Dale stepping in, and I remember their first welcoming service. Amanda said she was really organized, and back then I was like, okay, I like that. I'm an organized guy, I'm a neat freak, so I was like, you know, we'll be a really good friend, she'll be a great youth minister. And then we had our first trip. I don't even describe it. I'm sure people came up here and talked about it before, But it was a lot of drama, of course, and just a lot of stupid shenanigans. But I think the takeaway of the trip was that I am a heavy sleeper because
Amen.
we were in a tent overnight, and it was pouring rain, and me and my brothers were in the tent together, and so it was pouring rain. My brother Heath wakes up, and he sees that Hal is holding the tent. He's holding the tent up, and apparently the tent's caving in with the amount of water that's on it, and then Hal's like, go get somebody, go get Amanda, or go get Aaron, or go get somebody like that, and then Heath and Hal are like, wake up Ethan, and they're like, we gotta wake him up, and so I'm over there in my sleeping bag, and I'm just out cold. I mean, it was a long day, so I was just asleep, and the tent, I wake up, and the tent's open eyes, and I was like, I don't really want to wake up. So that was, I think that was a takeaway from the trip, not all the drama, of course. But all the events with Amanda were great. Amanda and Dale, we've had lock-ins, we've had Christmas parties, mission trips, ski trips. We did Operation Christmas Child a few times, a lot of Easter egg hunts, a lot of birthdays for Jesus, So it was a good time. Even though we didn't have the best first encounter, I've been thoroughly blessed with having you both in my life. And so, as I mentioned before, I went to youth, and then Amanda was the youth minister. And back then, I think there were five people, and there was Alexa, there was Zach, Alexa Rafferty, Zach Goodman, and then me and my brothers, Hal and Heath, and then, of course, Ethan. So we had a small youth group, and now, being in youth group and seeing everybody and seeing how much they've grown and see like the youth group has expanded, and we get more and more people, which is just a blessing. And as I got through, middle school and I went to high school, in high school, I got more close to Amanda Dale and the youth group, so that was a blessing. Sophomore year in high school, we decided to take a trip to Deep Impact Caswell, and of course everybody, I'm sure you've heard all about it, and that was actually where I decided to rededicate my life to Christ in the summer of 2011 at Fort Caswell, so that place has a special place in my heart. After I rededicated my life, Amanda, she coached me spiritually, my youth group supported me, you guys were praying for me, and that has just had the biggest impact on my life. I started getting involved with the praise band here, Laman, started being the drummer, and I decided to drop piano, even though I had wonderful lessons from Miss Becky. I just decided that I wanted to bang stuff with sticks, so I decided to play the drums. And it had it going for me until college. And then, the summer of 2012, when I decided to enroll at UCP, I knew everything was going to change. I knew, I wouldn't have my church family here. I wouldn't be able to come back to church every Sunday. I would be on my own for the first time in my life, which was a scary thought. And it is once you first go to college. I'm sure people can testify. So I left the church to be at school. I left Laman. I let Jay Dover play the drums for a little bit while I go off to further my studies. And I left the youth group, graduated from the youth group. And that was the first time I was on my own for my life. But I stand here today and I can testify that college is where I grew the most in my relationship with Christ. And it's a big test for believers once you enter in the college floor, so it's dangerous. You're surrounded by so many strong influences, bad and good, and it's really up to you if you want to continue your faith. And so, luckily, freshman year, of course, my brother Heath was ahead of me. He was a sophomore there. I got plugged into campus ministries on campus. I got plugged into a great church, made really good friends. But most importantly, the reason why college is where I grew the most in my relationship with Christ was because of the First Baptist Church of Rayford. I remember my mom and dad always saying, well, the church is praying for you, Amanda's praying for you, Dale's praying for you, we're lifting you up almost every Sunday. And that's what really has grounded me in my faith. I remember a lot of times, freshman year, sophomore year, where I was struggling in school, just like, I'm on my own, it's tough, but I remember there was that the spirit in me, and I felt it just carry me on through another day or carry me on through another week, and I know for a fact that was God. I know for a fact that was my wonderful church family praying for me, so that has impacted me deeply. All the prayers and the support that my family and the scholarships, of course, financially, it's tough to send three kids to college, so the scholarships are greatly appreciated. But First Baptist Church of Rayford this is my home church. You know, I remember playing drums right back there with Landon, and I remember sitting on the front row or sitting in the youth section as a little kid, like Pastor Tom said. I think I was asking something like that. This is my home. Rayford is my hometown. So Mom always says, don't forget where you came from. And I'll never forget this beautiful church, the beautiful facility, the beautiful people. It's been a blessing being here for 13 years, and I look forward to coming back for homecoming in the next 3 years. And I know that for a fact, that First Baptist Church of Rayford will forever be my home church, and my church family, and my second family. So I thank all of you so much for the impact you've had on me as an individual, and the impact you've had on my family. It's greatly appreciated, and I love visiting. I love coming back, getting all the hugs and kisses and stuff. And it's just a blessing to be a part of such a wonderful church family like you all. Thank you so much.